now it's time for us to get into some of the more advanced prompt parameters. And this is what you may have seen at the end of people's written prompts, where there's minus minus and it'll say something like AR 16x9, or to say minus minus test P. This is the part of the course where we're gonna get into using all of those and what those mean for your prompts. So let's go ahead and start with a brand new prompt. What I wanna do is try something we haven't done yet. Let's do a owl, let's do a portrait of an owl with ornate jewelry around the eyes and ears, comma, cinematic lighting. Actually, you know, let's do something different. Let's do studio lighting for this example. That's gonna give us a much more realistic look, as if it was shot in an actual studio with a three-point lighting setup. So let's go three-point studio lighting. And at the end of this prompt, actually, and I'm gonna add one more thing, photorealistic. And at the end of the prompt, I'm gonna manipulate or change the aspect ratio. So what Midjourney is gonna do by standard is it's gonna put out a 1:1 aspect ratio, which just simply means it's a square photo. Now there's different diameters that you can now make Midjourney export at. 9:16 is the standard vertical size of a vertical phone, like an Instagram story or a TikTok. 16:9 is the standard for a television or a computer screen. 3:2 is a standard for a photo taken from a camera. And 4:5 is pretty much the portrait mode of an Instagram post. So let's go ahead and let's do a 9:16 export. So what I'm gonna do is paste in minus minus AR, and AR stands for aspect ratio, and whatever number you put behind minus minus AR, that's gonna be the final dimensions of your post. So while that's rendering, I'm gonna copy what we did, and I'm gonna do a second version with a totally different aspect ratio. So I'm gonna do, instead of 9:16, let's do 16:9. And we're gonna let this render out. And here we have it. We have four different options of the 9:16 aspect ratio. This would be perfect for an iPhone wallpaper or a story post, or just sharing anything that you wanted in the vertical aspect ratio that's gonna fit better on a mobile device. Now, the 16:9 on the other hand, and these look really cool by the way, this is gonna be better for a screensaver or a wallpaper for a computer or anything really the shape or size of a TV screen. So you can really manipulate, you know, the dimensions, but the other thing I wanna keep in mind, or that I wanted to convey, is that it's also gonna slightly change the framing. I didn't give it any specificity on how to frame these, but Midjourney is gonna always do its best to fill the image with the content that's there. So you can see that it's showing a vertical, more, how do I say this? You're seeing the face and the body of the owl in the vertical aspect ratio. And then for these, you're just seeing an upper half or an upper quarter, much more close up of the owl. So to further convey how that's gonna affect your image, let's just say spaceship flying through space. And I'm gonna purposely keep this a little bit more broad, spaceship flying through space with planets in the background. So I'm gonna copy this and I'm gonna do our 9:16 aspect ratio. Send that out and we're gonna do this again. But instead we're gonna do the horizontal aspect ratio. And you're gonna see the content that it fills the frame with is going to change. So while this is loading, you always wanna keep these parameters at the end, because if you put more prompt behind it, it's actually going to give you a error message and it's not gonna be able to create your prompt. And so I'm glad that we did this second example, because this is the type of prompt and the type of image that's gonna be well suited seen in a horizontal aspect ratio. We wanna see a wide array of images, because this could be classified as a landscape type of photo. We're not looking for a close-up portrait of something that fits better in a vertical format. If we look at the vertical format, these look nice and fine, but everything feels a little bit compressed compositionally in the image. So we're not gonna get as much of a professional final output. You can see these, it just doesn't feel as right. The planets are like right behind the spaceship, and compositionally, it's just not as good of an image. So that's something to really keep in mind, that your aspect ratio is actually a really important parameter to play with. So if I'm trying to create a portrait of an animal or a person, I'm gonna wanna use the more vertical aspect ratios. And if I'm wanting to create a nice looking landscape that feels well weighted and well balanced and not too cluttered and visually would be more aesthetically pleasing with a wide angle view, I'm gonna use the more horizontal aspect ratio. So this parameter is really important when trying to really dial in that really perfect looking photo.